strong, caring, compassionate, heroic, a true gentleman. These are just some of the words to describe a man who once graced the planet with his presence. A man with morals, a man with decency, a man with a good heart. This is a documentary about my hero, my guidance, my father. This is the documentary about Steve Butler.
How did we first know Steve? From the Wheat Sheaf, which was my local watering hole.
I met your dad through my dad, because he got me a job with him. I didn't know him then, through the Wheat Sheaf.
How'd you sum Steve up?
Steve was quite a gentleman.
If he was your mate, he was a good mate. He had your back, he gave you the bloody, he gave you the last button off your shirt.
He had morals and principles.
He wasn't a bully, and he would never have seen anybody be bullied.
He was, to be fair, he was like my idol. You know, I used to look up to him. You know, whatever he said for me to do, I used to do. Because most of the time, well, 99% of the time, it was right.
Any particular memories you have of him from the pub?
Best one was when I was first 18 and I went to the pub, started drinking with him. And he said he was coming down in half hour's time. He lied to me, he was coming down in 10 minutes. He didn't used to know I smoked or anything. So as I went outside and had a crafty cigarette before he got there, all I felt was this massive hand touch the back of me saying, that'll stop before it starts. And as I turned around, there was him with a smile on his face. It was all good though, because he did buy me a beer after.
I've carried him indoors from the garden when he was completely unconscious.
Best, our ultimate, was the pub crawl from Gosport to Lee Park. Round Gosport, over on the boat, started at the Hard and worked our way all the way up Queen Street, and then we went to what was the Albany, it's not there now, can't remember what it is now, it's probably Greg's or something, and we went in there and it had an L-shaped bar, and I was stood at one, we were on the corner, and Steve went, drink up, we just got here for Christ's sake, drink up, what's the rush, drink up. There's plenty of blokes in here, it's all Saturday afternoon. Probably here for the football, is it? Half of them are holding hands. Okay. So, he said when we get outside, do not tell anyone in Lee Park that you took me into a gay bar. I'm like, hang on a minute. So anyway, we went to the railway station, we got a train up to Haven, we drove around Haven, we eventually ended up in the Wheat Sheaf. He walked in the Wheat Sheaf, ordered 2 pints and said, and this tosser took me into a gay bar.
What do you remember about him and your mother?
There were smiles on both of their faces. They had a happy relationship.
You know, your mum and dad were always there to support me no matter what I did.
How did you know my mum, his lovely woman Jenny?
Lovely woman Jenny was.
Never hid my feelings for your mum. I just thought she was a lovely woman. She was all good to me. As was your old man.
Yeah, she was a saint. She was brilliant. She never had a bad word to say. Or anything.
She was kind. She was a nice person. Brilliant sense of humour. She's missed. And she always will be.
So, what was he like working with Steve?
He loved his work and he was very good quite often.
He had his ups and his downs. But he was always funny and sarcastic every time he was on a roof with you.
Good. You had to work though. Because he was a grafter. The one thing about him was he bloody worked. I mean, he could walk in a pub on a Sunday afternoon and have a full working crew for Monday morning.
If Steve lost his temper with you at work, it was, he'd lose his temper, but after he'd had your bollocking, it'd be forgotten about.
What one word would you use to describe him?
He was a fair bloke.
He's a very clean person all the way through her life. Used to love having occasional drink on weekends and stuff, but everyone does.
Loyal. Mm. He was always loyal. If you were his mate, that was it. He would stand by, he would do whatever.
A diamond. Yeah. Diamond. Because he was. Diamond of a bloke.
Steve unfortunately passed away on the 7th September 2012 due to cancer. He passed away peacefully in his sleep. 4 years before this, Steve's loving wife Jenny was tragically taken from us. 8 years before she passed, she was diagnosed with heart disease, However, although quite ill, she was always a strong, caring, loving woman. She passed away on 14th September 2008. For the last 2 years of Steve's life, he remarried to a receptionist named Jackie, to which he lived comfortably in the peaceful town of Emsworth. Though time passes and years pass, in memory they'll never be gone. For the impact Steve and Jenny made on us, in our hearts, they'll always live on.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain.